written notes. Actually, some problems are not found in books normally, so I will give you those problems in handwritten notes. Now, Lagrange's mean value theorem. This is basically a generalization of the Rose theorem. Okay, so let me first tell you the statement. In the Rose theorem, there are three conditions. Okay, a function should be continuous in the closed interval. A function should have its derivative f dash x existing in the open interval. And why it is open interval, not closed interval? Did I discuss this thing? Why this open interval is taken for derivative? Is it discussed?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, let me tell you first. Okay, this is the thing. Why you have a question? You should have a question, sir. Fx is I'm taking continuous in the open interval, in the closed interval. That means including a b. So why you are not doing this for f dash x? The point is that if what is f dash x, tell me what is the definition of f dash x? Okay, in the last one or two, this one. Okay, that's we check this thing. This will be better. It will be easy to understand. What is the definition of f dash x at the point x? Suppose here I've taken a point zero. You can see the point zero. So what is the definition of derivative at the point zero? That will be f. In general, for any point x is equal to a, f a plus h, where h is a small increment. H is a small increment, so f of a plus h minus f a by h. So if I consider the point zero, that will be f of zero plus h minus f zero by h. Now, concentrate on this point that h is a very small increment. Now, it is not always necessary that h should be in the increasing form. Okay. So h can be a decrement also. It is a small change. So small change can be in the negative direction and in the positive direction. Okay, both are possible. So depending on that, we consider the derivative to be of two type: left hand side derivative and right hand side derivative. In the left hand side derivative, we consider h tending to zero minus, that h is slightly changed, slightly less than zero. So when h is slightly less than zero, then f zero plus h will be slightly less than f zero. That means if you, when we say this f dash zero existing, when this limit exists, simple, when this limit h tending to zero, f zero plus h minus f zero by h will exist. Now, if this is to be existing, then obviously the function value should be finite at zero plus h and zero, all these things. Now, when h is negative, then 0 plus h will be a negative value. So we are requiring that the function is existing in the left hand side of 0 also. Okay. Are you getting? Functions should be existing in the left hand side of 0 also because h is negative. Similarly, if I take the general case f of a plus h, then when h is slightly less than 0, so we are actually considering a point which is beyond the left extreme point a, beyond a on the left hand side. That means we are requiring that the function value should be again finite beyond the left hand side, beyond the extreme value of a. Okay, but that was not in the condition. The condition, what was the first condition? Function should be continuous in within a to b, closed interval a to b. But if I take the derivative to be continuous at a, we require that the function value should be finite again in the left hand side of a. If it is the right hand side of a, there is no problem. It is within the closed interval. Okay, within the closed interval a to b, a greater than a, so h is positive, so a plus h will be greater than a, no problem. But when h is negative, the left hand side derivative, then a plus h is slightly less than a. Are you getting? Slightly less than a. That means f should be existing at a point which is slightly less than a, but that is not given. That is contradicting the first point. That is, function should be continuous only within a to b. So there is a contradiction. This, we are assuming the function is continuous beyond a and beyond b. Similarly, for right hand side, if you take b, so b plus h, when you take the h positive, so b plus h should be a point slightly greater than b, slightly greater than b. So the function value should be existing at that point. That means we are requiring that the function's value should be finite beyond b on the right hand side. Is it clear? So that is actually contradicting the fact that it is first condition, that it is only continuous in the a to b closed interval. That is why we are taking only a less than x less than b. We are just not taking the a and not taking the b, the extreme values. Okay, I hope it is clear to all.
Yes,
any question? Anyone is confused still? There should not be any confusion. It is just from the definition of f dash x, it follows. If a plus h and a b plus h, this should be within a to b. So in order to keep it within a to b, we cannot take just a equal to a, isn't it? So if these two points are just same as the Rolle's theorem, fx should be continuous in the closed interval, f dash x should be continuous in the open interval, and the third point I am not taking, third point we are omitting, fa equal to fb, in that case there will be at least one point c within ab such that fb minus fa by b minus a, this should be equal to f dash c. So what is fb minus fa by b minus a? This is basically, okay, let us draw the curve. Okay, so this is the curve. This is the point x is equal to a, this point on x axis, this is the point on x axis, x is equal to b, measuring from O, and this a is the perpendicular drawn from x axis to the point. So this capital A will have the coordinate a fa, this perpendicular length is fa. Similarly, this b point will have coordinate b fb, and this perpendicular b to the x axis is fb. Okay, so what is fb? Fb, follow my cursor, what is fb minus fa? That is simply bm, where am is the horizontal drawn horizontal to the x axis, horizontal to the x axis. So basically this am and this mb, small b, are same. So capital bm, this is basically fb minus this fa, this is fa. Okay, so fb minus fa is bm. And what is am? What is am? Very simple, this is b minus a, this part. Okay, I'm already assumed a is less than b. I can always take either a less than b or b less than a, so accordingly I will arrange. So a less than b, so that will be b minus a. So bm by am, bm by am, what is that? That is the slope of this chord AB. AB is the chord connecting these two points, AFA and BFB. That means here by Lagrange's theorem we are saying that there will be at least one point C here, C, where the tangent, the slope of the tangent will be same as that of the chord AB. So there will be a tangent parallel to the chord AB. Is it clear to all? So FB minus FA by B minus A is equal to BM by AM, that is the gradient of the chord AB. That is F dash C will be the gradient of the tangent to the curve at the point CFC, which will be parallel to the AB. This is the geometrical interpretation of the Lagrange's mean value theorem. Okay, FB minus FA by B minus A is equal to F dash C, where C is a point within A to B. Okay, now see, obviously we just immediately go down to Rolle's theorem from Lagrange's theorem. If I have FE is equal to FA, FB is equal to FA, this third condition if we add, then this left hand side will be equal to 0, FB minus FA is 0, then F dash C will be equal to 0. That means this reduces Rolle's theorem. Okay, if this all the three conditions are there, there will be one point F dash C where F dash C will be equal to 0. That means tangent is parallel to x axis. So in the Rolle's theorem, tangent will be parallel to x axis. And in the Lagrange's mean value theorem, it will be parallel to the chord AB. Chord AB, where AB are the coordinates AFA and BFB. This is the difference, okay? But we can also prove Rolle's theorem, we can also define, derive Lagrange's theorem from Rolle's theorem. This is not very easy. From Lagrange's theorem to Rolle's theorem, it is very easy. From Rolle's theorem to Lagrange's theorem, this is not very easy. Okay, that we will solve a problem, how to derive Lagrange's theorem from Rolle's theorem. Okay, that we will show later. What I just shown you, it is the deduction from Lagrange's theorem to Rolle's theorem. Okay, Lagrange's to Rolle, and Rolle's to Lagrange's, we will again solve a problem later. Now, another form of Lagrange's mean value theorem. If I take B is equal to A plus H, where H is any change, Now, please remember that this h can be negative also. So we can as well have a minus h also. It is not necessary that h will be always positive. It can be a minus h also. Any change from a value. So for the present case, I am taking a plus h. So b is equal to a plus h. So b minus a will be equal to h, and c will be equal to any point within a to b that can be defined in the way a plus theta h. Suppose theta is equal to half. Always theta will be real number, 0 less than theta less than 1, already you know. So theta suppose half. So a plus h by 2, that will be a point less than a plus h and greater than a always. Suppose a plus h by 3, theta is equal to 1/3. So a plus h by 3, that will be a point greater than a, less than h, less than a plus h. So a plus theta h will be a point always inside a and a plus h. So we can write this thing as c. So f a plus h is equal to f a plus h f dash a plus theta h. This is another important form of Lagrange's mean value theorem. And further, we can take a to be zero, origin. We can set the a value, first value, to be origin. Always we can do that, this thing. Okay, we can do these things. So this value, this x is equal to a value. This can be always set to the origin. That's just one shifting of origin. We can take origin here. So without any loss of generality, we can always do that. So this, if we take a is equal to 0 and h is a small modification change about 0, about origin, we have fh is equal to f0 plus h f dash theta h. Okay. And again, later we will denote this h. Bolo. Okay. Anish Awad. Okay. So if I further denote this h to be x, then fx is equal to f0 plus x f dash theta x. This is basically called Maclaurin's form. And this form will be used, not this form particularly, the generalized form will be used to find the infinite series expansion, infinite series representation of various functions like sin x, cos x, tan x, exponential of x, log x, all these functions. We can find the infinite convergence series expression using this expression, Maclaurin form. But here I'm assuming that only first order derivative exists, and in the general case we will assume any order derivative exists. That we will come later, not now. So this is the another form of Lagrange's mean value theorem. Okay, geometrical interpretation we have already discussed. This is the figure. Now coming to the example. So verify Lagrange's mean value theorem for the functions. Fx is equal to x into x minus 1 into x minus 2, where 0 less than equal to s less than equal to half. First function. Okay, let us first try this first function. So fx is equal to this. And that is given by x cube minus 3x square plus 2x. If you simplify this thing, that will be x cube minus 3x square plus 2x. Okay, I will suggest everyone to sit, when you will sit for the class, take a piece of paper and pen so that you can calculate. Time to time, some calculation may be necessary. So x cube minus 3x square plus 2x. Now, a is 0, b is half. So what is f dash x? F dash x will be 3x square minus 6x plus 2. So f dash c will be 3c square minus 6c plus 2. And then fb minus fa. So we put everything in the expression of Lagrange's theorem. Fb minus fa by b minus a. What is b minus a? That is half minus 0. And f of half minus f0. So that will be equal to this. F dash c equal to fb minus fa by b minus a. Okay. Now simplifying, this half minus 0 is half. These two will be coming here. In the numerator, 2 into this. So after simplification, we get 12c square minus 24c plus 5 equal to 0. This is pretty straightforward. Everybody can do this calculation. I hope you can do it. So after calculation, you will do it. You will get this thing. Now, this equation has two solutions. C is equal to 1 plus minus root 21 by 6. Okay. All of you know the quadratic equation solution. Minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac by twice a. So using that, we get these two solutions. Now, this 1 minus root 21 by 6, this thing will be only lying within 0 to half. You can take a calculator and check this thing. This thing will be greater than 0 and less than half. But 1 plus this, 1 plus this will be obviously greater than 1. So greater than 1 means this is not lying within 0 to half. So 1 plus root 21 by 6, this will not be taken as a solution. Only 1 minus root 21 by 6, this will be taken as a point which is satisfying the Lagrange's theorem. So Lagrange's mean value theorem is satisfied for this given function. Okay. Any query, any question from this?
No, sir.
Everyone is clear? Feel free to interact me, but after 10 days, you don't tell me, sir, I could not answer these things. So, again, somebody is waiting. Arijit, you are clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Mohammad Sohel? Mohammad Sohel?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then, okay. The last two problems, I have just solved one problem, and second and third, I am not solving. I am leaving this as an exercise, okay? Fx equal to x cos 1 by x, for x not equal to 0, and 0 for x equal to 0 in minus 1. This is a broken definition, so you have to calculate f dash t with the definition. So please solve this thing by your own. And if you cannot solve this thing, I will solve it in the next class. Also, the third problem, these two problems I'm giving as an exercise. Everybody will try and show me in the next class. Okay? Got it?
Yes, sir.
And okay. Everybody try it. Then I'm solving a different problem. Suppose f dash c exists always and less than zero, negative, everywhere in the interval ab for a function ab, for the function fx. Now, then by using mean value theorem, show that fx is a decreasing function. Actually, we actually know these things because whenever df dx is less than zero, it is decreasing function. So from the mean value theorem, how can I show? So suppose x1, x2 are two arbitrary points in within the interval ab, in the taken in the ascending order, that is a less than x1, less than x2, less than b. We can always write take point in this way, no loss of generality. So then applying mean value theorem within x1, x2, what we can get? Fx2 minus fx1, that is fb minus fa, by x2 minus x1, that is equal to f dash c, where c is a point within x1 to x2. Now, we are given that f dash x always less than 0. So this is always less than 0, f dash c. Now, it is less than 0. So x2 minus x1, this is greater than 0. Because as the way I have taken them, x1 less than x2, okay? So x2 minus x1 is greater than 0. So obviously, we get fx2 minus fx1 less than 0 because the entire ratio is less than 0. That means fx2 is less than fx1. Fx2 is less than fx1. That means x2 less than x for every x2 greater than x1. So the function is decreasing. Hence, the function is decreasing function in AB. Okay. So by using mean value theorem also, we can deduce the same thing for decreasing and increasing function. Okay. And
excuse me, sir.
Next, we will solve. Next, we will solve some inequality.
Sir, some students are wait, sir.
Okay. Khan Sahib, why late? Can you hear me? Adrita,
yes, sir.
Why you are late?
Sir, I'm not late.
Not late. It is 12:25. Your class started from 12.
Sir, I was unable to join.
unable to
some
join.
connection problem.
Where from you are joining? Connecting?
Sir, from Google Meet, Asansol.
Not Google Meet. No. Where is your location?
Sir, Asansol.
आसनसोल से? आसनसोल से नहीं हो रहा है? ठीक है, मोबाइल से कर रहे हो क्या?
सर, नेटवर्क इशू, वाईफाई प्रॉब्लम.
देयर इज अ प्रॉब्लम, आई कांट हेल्प यू एक्चुअली. ओके, देन दिस टाइप ऑफ इनइक्वालिटी वी कैन एस्टैब्लिश, वी कैन शो यूजिंग मीन वैल्यू थ्योरम. दिस वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एप्लीकेशन ऑफ मीन वैल्यू थ्योरम. These inequalities otherwise will be very difficult to derive, okay? But using mean value theorem, we can derive it very easily. And this, but the point is that it will depend on, to some extent, to your experience or observation power, okay? But don't worry, at your level, there are only 2, 3, 4 such variations. I will solve other problems also. If you just practice some problems, it will be not an issue. So, for this inequality to show, you have to start with a specific function taken and apply mean value theorem on that. So what will be the function? The function will be e to the power x. The function will be e to the power x. Okay, let's check whether how this function, taking this function, I can establish this limit. Okay, that is the limit number one. And limit number two, second problem, second limit is this: x by 1 plus x less than log of 1 plus x less than x if x greater than 0. The second inequality, there are two inequalities. Now for the first inequality, fx is equal to e to the power x, we have to take. So from the mean value theorem, what you are getting, I told you, putting h is equal to x and a is equal to 0, we get the Maclaurin form in the restricted sense up to first order. Fx is equal to f0 plus x f dash theta x, where 0 less than theta less than 1. This is very important. Now, putting x, if x is equal to e to the power x, so f0 is equal to e to the power 0, that is 1. So e to the power x is equal to 1 plus x. Now f dash x, what is f dash x? Again e to the power x. So what will be f dash theta x? That will be e to the power theta x. Okay, so x into e to the power theta x. So e to the power x is equal to 1 plus x e to the power theta x. From that, you just calculate e to the power theta x is equal to e to the power x minus 1 by x. Then taking log both side, theta x will be equal to log of e to the power x minus 1 by x. So theta is equal to 1 by x log of e to the power x. So our strategy is to find theta. Sometime this may be changed. We cannot establish the inequality just by putting theta, deriving theta in terms of x and putting there. This may not be always useful, but for this problem, we just actually you have to solve the problem looking at the inequality to be solved. Okay, looking at the inequality to be solved, I got that I should derive theta in terms of x in this way. So now just put theta in this inequality of theta, 0 less than theta less than 1. Putting theta here, 1 by x log e to the power x minus 1 by x, we get this inequality, okay? So when you are solving problem, don't close your eyes blindly. Look at the expression you have to derive, and accordingly you drive your calculation, okay? Now for the second problem, we will solve similarly, sir, with the same similar minimal equation, but in that case, we have to take the function to be log of 1 plus x. And only not the functions will be changed, we will not be able to just find theta and putting there, that will not give you this inequality. Just a change in calculation is required. Let's see what happens, okay? But the second problem, so fx is equal to log of 1 plus x, so fx is equal to f0 plus x f dash theta x. So what is f dash x? That is 1 by 1 plus x. So what is f dash theta x? That is 1 by 1 plus theta x. So we have log of 1 plus x is equal to log 0, 1 plus 0, that is log 1, and log 1 is 0 basically, into x f dash theta x, so 1 by 1 plus theta x, okay? From that, we are getting, first of all, log 1 plus x is equal to x by 1 plus theta x. Now, from this, if we find theta in terms of x, that will not actually give you the inequality. Got it? That will not give you the inequality, okay? So in order to get the inequality, we have to just change the calculation procedure a bit. See, so 0 less than theta less than 1, this is given, and x is greater than 0. Okay, so we can always write this thing, multiplying with x both side, 0 less than theta x less than x, from this, okay? We could not write this thing if x was less than 0. Here theta is also greater than 0, x is also greater than 0. So if you multiply with x, the inequality will not change, okay? So 0 less than theta x less than x. Now adding 1 both side, we have 1 less than 1 plus theta x less than 1 plus x. So from that, if you take the reciprocal, the inequality will be, the less than will be greater than. It is obvious. Suppose 5 greater than 3. Are you getting? 5 greater than 3. So 1 by 5 will be less than 1 by 3. So if you take the reciprocal, the equality, inequality will be changed. So taking the reciprocal, 1 is greater than 1 by 1 plus theta x is greater than 1 by 1 plus x. Now again, multiplying with x, we get x greater than x by 1 plus theta x greater than x by 1 plus x. Actually, we did all these things to derive this term, x by 1 plus x. Here it was given x by 1 plus x. So looking at the problem, you have to solve. Looking at the problem, again, I'm telling. So x by 1 plus x, I have derived. Now, again, writing it from the reverse direction, okay? So a less than b, so obviously b greater than a less than b less than c, so c greater than b greater than a, obviously. So we will have x by 1 plus s greater than x by 1 plus theta s greater than a, sorry, x by 1 plus s less than x by 1 plus theta s less than x. Okay, this was greater than, so if I write it in a reverse direction, it will be greater than, less than. So we get x by 1 plus s less than this. Now x by 1 plus theta x. Okay, now we can substitute this thing with log of 1 plus x. So x by 1 plus x less than log of 1 plus x less than x. That will give you the inequality. I hope everybody is clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Just you have to look at the problem and then solve this way. But the main thing is that you have to use the inequality of theta. You have to use the inequality of theta and accordingly you have to calculate. Okay. Next. Okay. In the last problems, what we have seen, that in general, the expression of theta will involve some x. See here. Theta will involve some x, okay? Theta is a function of x, okay? Now, in this problem, the function is given to be a plus bx plus c m to the power x, exponential type. So that theta is independent of x in the mean value theorem, fx plus h is equal to fx plus h f dash x plus theta h. The point is that here x is taken to be the a. So a variable a is taken. Carefully look at the problem. They are given, they are saying that if we change the initial value a, if we vary this x randomly on the x-axis, so let it be denoted by x. So x is actually the variable. So I'm taking a to be the every x. Then for every a, every x, we can write down the mean value theorem in this way. So now they are showing that this theta will be independent of that x. So you just calculate the fx plus h and f dash x. That will give you fx plus h will be equal to this a plus b into x plus h plus c into m to the power x plus h. That will be equal to fx, that is a plus bx plus c m to the power x plus h f dash x plus theta x. That is h of b plus c into m to the power x plus theta h log m. Because derivative of m to the power please tell me. M d by theta h log m, and here will be 1 c to the power c into m to the power this one. All other bxa will be cancelled from both sides, and bh will be also cancelled. This bh, there is also bh, all will be cancelled. Now so from this next last relation, mh will be equal to 1 plus m theta m to the power theta h log m, because we can cancel m to the power x throughout the side. M to the power x, you can cancel, because m to the power x in general not zero. M to the power x we cannot take general not zero, so we can cancel this thing. So we have m to the power theta is equal to m to the power h minus 1 by log m. So theta is equal to, taking logarithm both side, 1 by h log m log of m to the power h minus 1 by log m. Now this expression is just independent of x. So it doesn't matter, the theta is not dependent where you are setting the initial point a. It will be just independent of a. If you take the function in this way, a plus bx plus c into m to the power x, it may not be true for other functions. Okay, it is in general a function of initial point and the increment in general, but for this function it is independent of the initial point. Okay, and next we will discuss Cauchy's mean value theorem. That is the generalized situation where two functions are used, f and g. Both are defined on closed interval ab, both are continuous on closed interval ab, both are derivable on open interval ab, and only the different condition is that g dash x, that is dg dx, that will not be zero all for any x in the open interval. G dash test cannot be equal to zero. If you follow these three conditions, if the function fg satisfy these three conditions, then we have the mean value theorem like this: fb minus fa by gb minus ga, that is equal to f dash t by g dash c, where c is again a point within a to b. Okay, now proof is not in your syllabus, I'm not discussing. Only we are discussing that we can immediately, why we are saying this is the generalized situation, because if you take gx to be x, okay, we are taking function gx to be x, such functions are called coordinate functions. Okay, gx is equal to x, then we are getting fb minus fa by gb minus ga, that is b minus a. Okay, what is gb? That will be b. What is ga? A. So b minus a. And what is g dash c?
Choice 1.
Whatever c you take, g dash c will be always 1. So f dash c equal to 1. Okay.
One.
And can you say why this condition g dash c not equal to 0 always? Anyone? Why g dash c not equal to 0?
So because denominator cannot be 0.
Because if it is 0, then the right hand side will be infinity, and the left hand side will be also meaningless. So no meaning. Sir. All are meaningful only in the finite values. So if the g dash c cannot be equal to 0, and for gx is equal to x, we just get down the Lagrange's mean value theorem. AB minus FA by B minus A equal to F plus C. Okay. Now, again, by putting B is equal to A plus H and C is equal to A plus theta H, as usual, the Cauchy's mean value theorem can be written in this way. Same thing, F A plus H minus FA by G A plus H minus G is equal to F plus A plus by G dash A plus theta H. Okay. This, now, from this expression, a very important working rule should be defined, that you know this rule. Do you know How many of you know or
yes,
use
sir.
L Hospital's rules?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Everybody,
yes, sir.
Because in the competitive exam, you will every time you will need to use to break the complicated limits. We have all used complicated limits. You have solved using love. Now this L Hospital's rule are derived from Cauchy's mean value theorem. Okay, I will show you in the next class how the L Hospital's rule is derived from Cauchy's mean value theorem. Okay, from this. Now, in this class, we will conclude this class by verifying Cauchy's mean value theorem for the following pairs of function: f(x) is equal to sin x, g(x) is equal to cos x, and ab is equal to minus pi by 2 and 0. A is minus pi by 2, b is 0. So this is the first set of functions. Second set is f(x) is equal to root x, g(x) is equal to 1 by root x, and ab is equal to 1, 2. For the first function, so sin x and cos x always they are continuous because they have only value from minus 1 to 1, always finite value, and always derivable at all points in the real number. So they have no problem to satisfy the condition 1 and 2 in the Cauchy's mean value theorem. So we put these things fb minus fa by g minus a. So what is fb? Sin b, sin minus pi by 2. What is the value of sine minus pi by 2? Tell me. What is the value of sine minus pi by 2?
Minus 1.
Because sine minus theta is minus sine theta. And cos minus theta is cos theta. So it will be minus 1, minus 0. And gb minus ga. So gb will be 0. And g 0 is 1. So 0 minus 1. So minus 1 minus 0 by 0 minus 1. That will be equal to f dashed. Okay, let's see in the this one the thing. So 0 minus minus 1, 1 minus 0, that will be equal to f dash c by g dash c, that is cos c minus sin c. Okay, this will be your Cauchy's mean value theorem. From that we are getting immediately cot c is equal to minus 1. Okay, so that will give you c is equal to minus pi by 4. Now minus pi by 4 is a point within minus pi by 2 to 0. So Cauchy's theorem is verified for this function, for this pair of function. Okay, for this pair of function we verify that. So that means verify, what do you mean by verification? You can have a point c, we can get a point c within it ab, so that this fb minus fa by gb minus ga is equal to f dash c by g dash c. Okay, again the next problem I am not solving, very easy problem, similar way you can solve it. Okay, again I am giving this as an exercise to you, all of you. Next day I will ask everybody whether they have solved the problems. Okay,
so actually hello
bolo
sir, wo puchna tha ki aaj hum join kiye hain to pehle ka backlog wagera kaise complete hoga?
Backlog kiska backlog hai? Attendance ka?
सर ये मतलब पहले का जितना भी पढ़ाई वगैरह
वो है, पढ़ाई तो... देखो पहले का एक क्लास हुआ था रोज थ्योरम पर. ओके, एक क्लास हुआ था रोज थ्योरम पर. रोज थ्योरम का मटेरियल ये सब हम शायद भेजा है ग्रुप में, क्लास नोट्स कुछ भेजा है?
यस सर.
तो अभी भी हम ये जो कितना तक भेजा है बता सकते हो? कितना तक देखो तो कितना तक भेजा है?
टेन
तक ना, उसके बाद नहीं भेजे? ओके, तो 10 से हम भेज देते हैं अभी.
ओके,
15-20 तक ज्यादा एक साथ लेकर क्या करोगे? सो हु वाज टेलिंग मी अब द बैकलॉग
रोशन माइक बंद करो.
अंकिता ना, तो अंकिता यू फॉलो द क्लास नोट्स, नॉट मच थिंग हैज बीन डिस्कस्ड, ओनली सम रोज थ्योरम. आई होप यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम द नोट. और हाँ, that will be if the first go through the note. Okay, then if you have any problem, later you can call me. Okay, or in the next class okay. I will clarify. Okay.
Okay, sir.
And everybody give the attendance. It is open now. Within 5 minutes, everybody give the attendance. You have got the link, na? Everybody have got the link.
Sir, I have gave the attendance at the beginning of the class.
ग्रुप डिस्क्रिप्शन
सर, लिंक नहीं है सर, अटेंडेंस मैंने पहले ही दे दिया था.
अटेंडेंस क्या किए थे, पहले ही दे दिया था?
यस सर, क्लास ज्वाइन करने से पहले
ठीक है, ठीक है, तो ओके ओके ओके, इट्स ओके. सो वी आर कंक्लूडिंग टुडे, बाय एवरीवन.
थैंक यू सर.
धीरे धीरे चलो, देखो ऑनलाइन क्लास में ज्यादा मटेरियल एक साथ पढ़ा देने से ना कोई फायदा नहीं, थोड़ा धीरे चलो, लेकिन मेक श्योर यू आर गेटिंग एवरीथिंग, यू आर ग्रास्प द आइडिया. सो टाइम बहुत है, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं, ठीक है, डेफिनेटली, बट स्लोली चलो, स्टेडीली.
थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू सर.
बाय एवरीवन.
बाय सर.
थैंक यू सर.